y'all tried to skip the process. Y'all just wanted to go straight to the store. And you thought you had that kind of hair where you could just go to the store and buy the activator and rub it a little bit off. But you're going to have curls. You got to look in the mirror. So that didn't work. It didn't work because you didn't go through the full process. Okay, y'all have a minute. Okay. How many ladies here remember the day before wigs? Where you had to go to the hairstylist, you had to get a perm. Mm-hmm. Oh, so y'all didn't know what a perm is.
Suzanne and Madam Walker.
Oh, y'all gone after since wigs came out, right? So my mom. And when she would go and she would sit down, and this lady, her name was Mrs. Holmes, Miss Mary Holmes, she was a godly woman. And then, boy, she would get this lard, and she put this lard in my mom's hair, and she would rub it in. And when she put it in there, boy, lie. For a 9-year-old boy, it looked just like Crisco. And when she ain't stopped there, you know, but I'm sitting there about to choke as a little boy, and the chicken smells so bad back then, right? And boy, that's what they have, I figure out how to deodorize or something. They put that lard in that hair, they would comb it through and say, baby, go sit over there for a minute, right? And then when you would sit there for about 30 minutes, but boy, if you left it too long, your hair would fall out. They put grease all around the hair. It costs about $8 just the supplies to get a perm, right? And so they put all that stuff on there, and they would leave it on there just long enough to make your hair straight. Mm-hmm. But boy, if you cut the process short, and boy, you remove the perm too quickly, it would make an impact, but it wouldn't totally straighten your hair out. And guys, I'm not really talking about hair, I'm talking about what God does. God